Councillor Cordover.
Thank you, Mayor. It's really important for transparency, for authenticity, for integrity that we maintain this policy. And also part of the process is actually reviewing this policy as we do from time to time, every 4 years, to make sure that things don't fall through the cracks. As you alluded to, Mayor, I don't think, fortunately, I guess that nobody gets any gifts really that I'm aware of. But if they did, I think it's really important that we have a mechanism for recording those and making sure that it's above board and that it avoids not just the actual risk of compromise, but also the perception of risk of compromise, which is equally as important. And if we go back through our Councillor Code of Conduct and indeed the Local Government Act, there's many references in there to how important it is to avoid those conflicts of interest. And we know also from things like the Kingborough Chronicle just talked about donations, and donations reform is hot on the agenda in the state sphere, and it's obviously pertinent to council as well, because one of the luxuries of being so close to the people is that we have really close interactions with the people in our community. As Councillor Bastone was mentioning earlier in a different debate, we know our neighbourhoods, we know the people in our neighbourhoods, and that's one of the real privileges of being part of local council, but it also means that there's a really big risk there. And one of the ways that we can mitigate that risk of conflict of interest is by having a very clear and apt councillor gifts and benefits policy. And so that's why I'm really proud to be seconding this. And I also encourage members of the community to take an active interest in the local government as well, in local council. One of the main ways that we can hold our councillors to account is by taking an active interest in the business of council, and not just leaving it to faceless people around a table somewhere else, but actually getting involved. So I thank the author and the authoriser of this report, and I welcome the policy, and I'm proud to second it. Thank you.